Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, you will learn how to work with the control application and also how to create custom forms for your own projects. With the control application, you can validate information, generate processes, or build custom login screens, as well as custom forms. Within Scriptcase, I will start by creating a new application. I will select the control type application. I will leave the default name and not make any other selections for the time being, and simply select the create button. Okay, so now I have created a standard control application. If I now go to run this application, it will display an error message, as I have not yet created or added any new fields. To create or add new fields within the left menu, I need to first select fields and then the new fields option. Here I will go ahead and create three new fields. I can add as many fields as I want, but for this example, I will only add three and click the next button. Now the first field, I will change the type to a multi-lines text and provide it the name description. For the second two fields, I will select for both the type as integer and provide a name of value 1 and value 2. Now here we can also customize the label if it is different than the name of the field that we have added. For this example, I will leave them as they are, as the label will be populated by the name, and for me that is satisfactory enough at this moment. So I will go ahead and click create, and the new fields will be added to the form application. With the fields added, notice that I am immediately viewing the last added field, so I can already begin customizing the field value 2. Okay, so now I have added some fields to this control application. I am now able to run and test the new control application. So if I go ahead and click run, I can now view the control form with the three fields I have just added. By default, the form also includes an OK and exit button, which both can of course be customized and adjusted to your own needs. Okay, so back into Scriptcase, I will make some further customizations to this new form. First, I want to change the description field, and I want to change this to a label type. And now I will add some text into this field. Now the text indicates that the form generates all necessary records and routines for information migration. Just something random for this example. And I will now also remove the label contents, as it's not required for a label field, and run the application again to see what it looks like. So now within the form, we can see that we have the label data, which I've added. We don't have a title, as it's really not required, or the label field, which I just removed. And this text just gives some basic information on what the purpose of this form is. So now returning back to Scriptcase, I now want to make some adjustments to the form layout. So I will access the left-hand menu and then settings. And now here I will change the table width to 20, and I will also change the table unit width to percent, and again run the control application and see those changes. So as you can see, now I have now made the form thinner so that the form is more readable and it doesn't expand when viewing on larger screens. Okay, so now I need to provide some functionality to the two value fields I had added. So let's return back to Scriptcase, and what I will do now is add a simple validation, which can usually be quite complex, by using some of these Scriptcase macros. And the reason for that is to add some functionality. So I will need to access events in the left-hand menu, and here I will use the onValidate option. And now within the code editor window, I will paste a little snippet which I have previously prepared. So what I'm doing here is, if the value entered in field value 2 is lower than the value entered into field value 1, then I will display the user an error message using the SC error message macro. And if the form does validate, then it will display the user an alert. Ouch. That hurt. Okay, before I go ahead and run the app again, I want to also change the buttons displayed, because as you can see within the form, we have an OK and an exit button. So within the left-hand menu, I will select the toolbar menu item, and here I can adjust the positioning of the buttons. For the exit, I will move that to the left, and the OK, I will move to the right. Below that, I would also change the label of the OK button, and I will specify validate. And if I run the form again, we can then view the new changes applied. We can also go ahead and test the validation I had added. So if I go ahead and enter 3 and then 1 and click the validate button, I have the error message displayed, you're too low, your value is 3. So if I go ahead and change the value to 1 in value 1 field, and in the value 2 field, I'll change to 3, click the validate again, and this time I have the error message Ouch, that hurt. Okay, so back into Scriptcase, and I will add a new button. Now within the left-hand menu, I will select Buttons, expand that, and then click the New Button option. Now I will call this new button Process, and the type, I will select PHP, and click the Create button. Now I again have some pre-prepared code. I will paste that into the editor window. So here, SC confirm, echo, and then also SC exit. So here I'm using the SC confirm macro to display the user a confirmation window. Then I'm going to use the echo statement that will process and continue. And below that, I'm then using the SC exit macro so that once confirmed and the OK button is clicked, it returns back to my application. So for further information on the macros available, do view our website. We have all the information there that you may need on each macro available, as well as examples and indications of how they should be used and how they can be used for your own applications. And before I go ahead and run the form, notice that I have made some slight adjustments to my code, which was spelt incorrectly. It is very important that the SC underscore for each macro provided is in lowercase and not uppercase. Now this tends to happen when you copy and paste from a Word document, for instance, so making those adjustments would be very important before running your application. Now if I go ahead and run the control application now, and within the control application, I now have the process button available. Clicking that, we'll open the confirmation window. We have nothing displayed or echoed within this window, and clicking the OK button will present again an OK button, which is then the SC exit, which we have been using within the control application. Clicking OK will return back to the form. So as you can see during this video, with the control application, you can create and include any type of custom form that you need, validation or process you may like, with a few clicks. And by including some of these Scriptcase macros and a few lines of text, you can have just about any type of form performing any kind of task that you need. Okay, so let's continue, but now I will go back a few steps and create a new control application. This time, I will select the HTML template option. So let's return back to Scriptcase, and again, I will select to create a new application. Again, I will select the control application, and this time below the options, notice that you have the option available, set the template HTML manually. If I check that and then click the create button, you will notice that on form creation, we have some slight differences. So the standard option here is HTML from the user, which allows you to hand code your page directly into Scriptcase. So here we have an example of a HTML form. We have also then the CSS, which we can code here manually, JavaScript, and also the option to use an external library. So if I select HTML and preview, I have a small preview of what the form would look like. So to the right, as mentioned, we have a check button. So clicking this will provide us some information regarding the content of our form. So for instance, we have some required fields and some optional tips available. So required is SC field class, SC form attributes, SC form hidden, form submit call info, the JavaScript library, as well as the page character set. The title is optional, and above that we also have some further tips which on clicking any of these will provide us further information on what is actually indicated. Okay, so let's return to the external library, which I kind of jumped over pretty quickly. And selecting that, we have here the option to not use an external library or an option to use an external library. Selecting use external library will provide us with some Scriptcase samples we can use, as well as the public library and also the project library and user library. Remember that we can keep our own customizations specific for the project, for the user only, or for public usage, which can then be used for all projects created within Scriptcase. So now within the Scriptcase samples, I will drop down the form list, and here I will select form 1 as the form that I want to use as my template. Now if I go ahead and click the preview button, I now have the form selected and ready to use. I will go ahead and click close. After that, it is important that on selection of a form or template to use within the control application, that we then select the Create Fields button within the top right corner. So here we will then be presented with all of the fields which have been added to the custom form. So within this template, we have the Confirm Password field, the Email field, Last name field, Password field, and a User field. Here we can change the data type that we want to use for these fields, as well as change the label. When you're ready, you can just go ahead and click the Save button. As a final resolution to confirm that everything is okay, go ahead and click check again and you will see the information update. For instance, now with this form template, we have the optional SE page title not included. Clicking that will display the relevant information, and if wanting to, we can go ahead and add that to our template. But now, because this is a sample template, it is best to actually create your own. So what we can do is, within the top menu, we can select Tools, and there I can then select the External Libraries within the main menu. Now here I can select to save the samples library, which I already have. So here we have all libraries that we have available, as well as those that I have added myself. So from the Scriptcase sample, I will go ahead and select the Save As button. And here I can adjust the library for which this will be placed in. So I will select Project so that it is only available within the current project that I am working on. And here I will change the name to Templates. When I'm ready, just click Save As. Now scrolling down within the project area or folder, we can now select to use this library. So for any library that we want to use within our project, we need to access the external libraries, select to use it first of all, and then save the project libraries. Now this will then include the library that we want to use into the project, allowing us then to use the library files within our Scriptcase applications. So now that we have created our own library, we can of course go ahead and edit the files. So if I click Edit, we can access here the form. And for the form one, if I click Edit here again, so when viewing the external library, I can select the form and I can also go ahead and edit the field values, add new fields, and customize the form further. For more information on customizing and creating your own external libraries, please check our website for more information. Okay, so let's return back to the control application. And now what we want to do is refresh our form. So I will click Save, and instead of using now the Scriptcase samples, I will select the project, and within project, I will select the templates, form, and again, the form one. Here I will again need to go ahead and create the fields to make sure that the fields are all available within the control application. When no new fields are found, this will be indicated, ensuring that everything is okay. Remember also to always check the check button to make sure that there are no errors or further requirements within the form. When you're then ready, you can go ahead and click the run button, apply your processes, any events that you may need, and your form will then be ready to go. Now do note that within the control panel, we still have the forms available which have been created for this application. So when clicking the create field, each of those fields is generated and added into the control application. If changing, for instance, the template, you will need to remove these fields if they are currently not available within the form. We can also select any of these. We can also make further adjustments to the field values and customize the form further. Don't forget that there are events that we can use. For instance, on the onScriptInit, we can specify that when this form is loaded, that a specific action is performed. Or for instance, on the onValidate, so when the OK or Submit button is clicked, that the form then sends an email or creates a process or runs through a process, whatever is required for your own project and custom form. As with most Scriptcase applications, you can code your events and make various changes to how your form interacts with your users. And with the optional custom HTML forms, you can create just about any type of form you need, update it easily, and customize it as you please. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.